Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. Today we have an exciting topic for you, especially if you are making the big switch from Windows to a Mac. Let's get started what it looks like to move from Windows to a Mac operating system. So as soon as you turn on the Mac, you're presented with the login screen. The account, it's going to be either your iCloud account, and it depends on how you set it up initially, or it is a local account particular to this PC. Just like in Windows, you're going to simply enter the username and the password. Now that we are logged into the Mac, let me go over some of the key components that we see and compare those components with those of Windows so that you can make the connection between the two. On the very bottom, this is what's called the dock. The dock is very similar to the Windows taskbar, which has a listing of icons in Windows, as you may be familiar. But here, the icons are a little larger and more visually appealing. On the very left, we have the Finder. The Finder is what opens by default once you're logged in, so you're able to find stuff in your computer. In this case, it's displaying the various applications that have been docked or tagged to show up on the docking area. As this is opened, notice that the Finder here on the top, it has this menu of the various options, and this will be typical when you use an application in the Mac OS. There'll be the menu on the very top, that stuff that you have opened, and then you can launch the applications directly from here in the bottom. So if I open Safari, notice that now I have the Safari window that opens up. The Finder is also used to locate files similar to the Windows File Manager, and I'll be getting into more detail on the ins and outs of it. You have here the recent files, you can locate applications, stuff on the desktop, documents, downloads, iCloud, and network locations. One thing that you may be noticing at this point as a new user of a Mac is that instead of the controls for these windows being here on the right-hand side, like in Windows, on a Mac, the controls are on the left. So you have the X to close the window. The little minus sign here is to minimize this window. And then the green is to make it full screen or tile to the left or to the right of the screen. And this is consistent through any of the applications that you open on a Mac. As part of the dock, you also, another component here is the launch pad. And we'll get into that shortly. Safari, this is the web browser for Mac OS, which is similar to Chrome, Firefox in Windows, or Microsoft Edge. Messages, this is that component that it ties really closely to the integration with your mobile phone. You can receive and send text messages directly from your Mac. Next, you have the mail. This is the built-in mail application. Now, if you had Microsoft Outlook on this Mac, you'd be using Outlook as well, or you can use the mail application directly from the MacBook. Maps, you can launch and navigate the Apple Maps. Pictures, it ties to your pictures. And FaceTime, the calendar, contacts, reminders, notes, Apple TV, Apple Music, podcasts, news, and the App Store. Now, the Apple Store, it's much more superior on the Mac. That's where you'd be able to download the various applications. Here is System Preferences. This will get you to change settings on the system and then various applications. This is productivity software that comes as part of Apple. And in this case, I have downloaded and installed Pages. To the right, typically you have the downloads option. This is where all your downloads will show up. The recent downloads will be here in the bottom. And then to look up downloads, you can either open up Finder here in the left and go to downloads, or you can come over here to the right and go to downloads and notice that Camtasia was the last thing that I downloaded. And then you can also open up Finder, and it'll be as if you click on this Finder icon here on the left. On the right here, you have a little tutorial on how to use the MacBook, and on the far right, the trash, equivalent to the Windows recycle bin. So if I have something that I have deleted, that's where it will be stored. and you can empty this trash directly from here by clicking on the empty button. Obviously, once you delete something, it's going to be nearly impossible to get it back. So that's components of the dock area. Again, it's very similar to the taskbar, but centered and more visually appealing. Now you can remove stuff from the taskbar from here. To remove it, notice I'm right-clicking or tapping on the pad here and choosing options, and this will remove it from the dock, or you can show it wherever it's launched from the Finder, from the File Manager or File Explorer, and so on. Or you can open the app from here. So basically, you can dock items in there, or you can take items off from here as necessary. So to remove an item here from the dock, you simply click on it, hold it down, and then drag it and throw it to the bin. And notice it says remove from the dock. Now on the very top, it will show this menu of the various options for that particular application. Despite whatever application you open, there is also the Apple icon here on the very top left. And this is another way that you can get to the various settings for this Mac. So you can learn about this Mac. You can go to the System Preferences, to the App Store, the app. Force quit is to close an application forcefully. It's like end task in Windows. Typically, you don't need to do that. But let's say right now I have Safari opened and I want to force quit Safari. I click here on the Apple icon, click on Force Quit, and it asks me, what do you want to close in this case? And I want to close Safari to force it. And there it is. The System Preferences, this is where you'll look at the various settings for this MacBook. This is where you'll change and check out the various settings for this system. So you click here on System Preferences, and it will display all the various options, such as your Apple ID, the sharing, and so on. General settings, desktop and screen saver, the docking bar, how to display it, mission control, Siri. It's also integrated into this, and the various passwords, users and accounts, and so on. So a lot of the settings are very common to what you typically have on an iPhone. And then various updates, Bluetooth devices, and so on. You can search for this stuff from here as well. So if you're not sure where something is located, you can search for it. And this would be similar to the searching in Windows 11, the Windows search. Comparing this with Windows, this would be like the settings area in Windows to get to all your settings in your device. To the right, we have the settings for the battery and battery preferences and so on. Then for your connection to the Wi-Fi, this is where you select your Wi-Fi connections and add new connections and so on, or net preferences. You have this search icon here, and this is where you can bring up the spotlight search. That will search for everything in your computer. It will search from items from the browser, from music, Apple Store, and maps, and so on. To the right of this, you also have this icon where you can control the various settings, such as the display brightness, to turn on and off the sound. So this is similar to the control settings on the bottom right in Windows 11 that you may be familiar with. To the right, here is where you have the Siri option. You can enable Siri, and it will perform searches very similar to how you use it in an iPhone. On the far right, where we have the date time, you can click on it, and it will display the various notifications, various widgets, somewhat similar to what Windows now does with Windows 11 widgets. But this is where your notifications will show up on the Mac. So I hope this is helpful, just to give you an idea to navigate the interface on the Mac OS. Please stay tuned for the other modules. I'm going to go into more detail about using the various components and how to go about familiarizing yourself with a Mac OS.